I'm Tifa.
I'm Penny.
And today, of all days, you see our hoods are up. We're either going to be talking about gangsters or something that's horrifying.
Yeah, so today we're going to be talking about the Nun 2, which can horrify a couple of gangsters if you go and watch it. But I am looking forward to this movie because according to some critics, it's much better than part one.
Ooh, that's spicy. Wait, let me just take off my hood. I'm kind of creeping myself out.
So have you watched part one?
I've watched part one, and let's just say that even though I'm not a horror film buff, it was a bit meh. Like, the story was just running.
Facts.
Don't know where it was going. Like Forrest Gump, it just kept on going down a straight line. But it's interesting that you say that, Penny.
Yeah, because I'm a big scaredy cat when it comes to horror movies. So I was expecting the Nun 1 to be like, oh my god. But I watched it and I wasn't even that scared. And that's saying a lot coming from me. Like, ask anyone that knows me. So when I heard about the Nun 2 and I watched the trailer, it's looking good. I feel like I want to live on the edge with this one.
And you can expect that because it's like from the Conjuring universe, obviously they're gonna write in the beginning based on a true story.
Bro.
That always gets me every time. Like, why do you have to reveal it? Why can't you put it at the end?
Makes it even worse when you see it at the end.
True, after you lived all that horrifying details. Well, it's from the Conjuring universe and you can expect the demons are just scary. What's going on with their makeup? Or is it even makeup? Or did they capture a ghost to come and act?
Did they hire an actual demon to come?
Because that is not funny, guys. Like, please.
And I like how in this movie, like compared to the Conjuring movies and to the other nun, you know, the first nun movie, Valak, the evil demon nun, she kind of is just in the background. You know, you see her, but she's not necessarily seen. Like, she doesn't really make a blatant appearance. I think that kind of adds to the whole mystery and like the fear of the unknown kind of thing, which kind of makes it a little bit more scary. And what I love about this movie is that the designers for the costume, there were like specific designers that were made to create Valak's habit so that they can make the veil from a, you know, special type of material that will give it that eerie look.
I'm not cringing because you're talking. I'm just thinking about all the people who have screamed just looking at Valak. And the fact that it was brought up in one movie, then it sprung into another movie. And now that everybody's just going around this topic, I feel like they should shoot it in a very, really good location because it really needs that element.
Fun fact, they did shoot on location. They went all the way to Paris. Yeah, now they've kind of ruined the most romantic place on earth for me because I don't want to go there anymore, kind of. I still want to go, but I'm a little bit more cautious now about the places that they've shot at. But they actually went on location to this cathedral that was built in the 17th century. So they used that as like, you know, in some scenes of the movie. So that should be interesting. Plus, old buildings always give me the creeps. So it's no surprise that they used the 17th century building.
So if you have a bunch of scaredy cats like Penny and I, don't worry about it. Just tell them that the movie is almost 2 hours. Don't specify, just say almost 2 hours. Because that's the amount of times that they will be clenching onto their seats and not eating popcorn.
Also, disclaimer, last week, Joey was telling us about this couple that took their little baby to the cinemas to watch The Nun 2. This is not for kids, okay?
Exactly.
Your child is going to be screaming throughout the whole movie. Don't do that to them. That's like Nightmare Fuel 101.
Okay. If this was a teaching moment, The Nun 2 is not a place to be teaching anybody. You're teaching adults to live within their means, bro. So don't do that.
Also, we're very sad to say that this will be our last episode of the F96 Flick It series. We really did enjoy watching all of these movies with you and talking about them with you. And if you have any more ideas on what we can talk about, let us know in the comments. And make sure you like and subscribe to our social media platforms,
which is YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Threads, Twitter. If you're thinking about it, we got it.
And remember to cheer on our boys tomorrow morning at 3:45 when they'll be playing against Australia. Hopefully there's no bad refereeing this time.
Or ghost, because it's in France, so.
Oh, you're done.
I think it was a ghost who cost us the game. But Cheer on the Fiji boys because we're gonna get them.
Okay, don't ever do that again.
Sorry.